Hello YouTube. So today I'm canning up the last 8 pie pumpkins that I bought at the green market. I've already cut the tops off. Now I just have to cut them in half, core them, separate my seeds, peel them and dice them in 1-inch chunks, and then I'm gonna boil them for brink. Okay, so I'm working on canning up the last 8 pie pumpkins that I bought at the farmer's market out of 30. So I've already got a couple cases of jars canned and put back to use in anything from soups to donuts to waffles to smoothies, anything you can think of. And these seeds I'm gonna save and roast. The innards to the pumpkin are gonna go in my vermicompost bin, and as well as the peels, the skin, so nothing is wasted. Kind of easier to get in there with your hand than a spoon. Once you have pumpkin guts all over your hands get kind of slippery, and then you're all over the place with the spoon. And from 30 pie pumpkins, I have a lot of seeds to roast. And the pumpkin seeds we can use over salad, healthy snack. So I'm going to finish cutting these in half and coring them, and then I'll bring you back for the next step. Okay, I've halved and cored some of my pumpkin. Thank you. kind of easiest to go in there and just initially scrape the majority of it out with your hand. This definitely isn't the easiest of tasks. It's definitely something that requires time, not something you can walk into in a rush and be done in 30 minutes. Like I said before, I started out with 30 pumpkins and it's taken me about 2 weeks to get them all put up. And I've had a few people ask me questions about the level of work that I put into canning. And, you know, it's more than it's so much deeper than the level of work that's put into it. These days, unless you're buying locally certified organic, where you know your farmer, you know the environment that your food is being grown in, you just can't trust a lot of food sources out there. There's so much contamination, so much craziness going on, that whenever you can make something on your own and know what it contains and know what you're feeding your family, that's just one point where, you know, it's a lot bigger than the work that goes into it. You're talking about your family's health. And if you're anything like me, trying to feed a family in this economy with food prices constantly rising, everything constantly rising, I don't want to feed my kids preservative-laden junk. I don't want to cause my kids health problems. I want to know what they're eating, that they're eating healthy. That, and think about it, buying locally grown. Not only do you know, have the benefit of knowing your food source, but you're also supporting local agriculture. You're supporting your local farmers. Which is also better for the environment. It's better really all the way around. Supporting your local farmer is supporting your community. And I think that's something that we as a whole have gotten away from. afford to eat organic. But this way, like this pumpkin, for instance, there's nothing in these jars but pumpkin and water. No preservatives, no chemicals, no crap. So many health problems out here. Caused by diet. And all the chemicals that we're putting into our bodies. From food sources that we have no idea where they're sourced from. Half the time, the stuff isn't even labeled right. Something in the news not too long ago. I think it was about fish that were imported from another country, and it was labeled as U.S. farm raised. Okay, so now I've got my pumpkin cored. I'm gonna slice them, peel them, cut them in 1-inch chunks, and then I'm gonna put them in a pot of boiling water and bring it back to a boil for 2 minutes, and then I'm gonna pack them in jars, cover them in water up to 1-inch head space, and process quart jars for 90 minutes and pint jars for 55 minutes. So I'll be back once I have these peeled, diced into 1-inch chunks, and ready to go into the boiling water. Okay, so I finally finished the pumpkin and I'm canning it up. Jars sterilized. Okay, so I'm canning up the last of the pumpkin. This has been cut into 1-inch or so cubes, put in boiling water and brought back to a boil for 2 full minutes. Okay, so I'm canning up the last of the pumpkin and filling my jars to 1-inch head space. Debubbling my jars. Fingertip tight. Okay, so according to the Ball Blue Book, I have cored, peeled, cubed, and boiled my pumpkin for 2 minutes before adding it to my jars. Okay, so I've got 10 quart jars in my 41.5 quart All-American canner. I'm about to put the lid on. And let this bad boy do its thing. And once this comes to pressure,
Thank you.